beautiful product.
Okay, so
yeah.
We've got the two kinds of a fiber here.
Yeah,
oh, this is some Cheviot.
This Russian dude, he's gonna spin. He's really good.
I'm not Russian. I'm Russian.
Yeah, that sounds Russian.
I don't know why you have a plug going over this wall.
I drape it all over the place.
You drape your wall bad. This is the preparation. You have it all ready here. God darn
it. Got your tensioning arm.
I think I might have to.
Give yourself a little bit of.
More fresh.
That's beautiful, beautiful.
I find you can like literally just do this. If you put your finger out by the bar, by the fire, you just do that. I think it's a little bit easier though.
Now remember, put it around your tensioning arm. Other way. Oh, no, you got it. Comes out of there at a 45 degree angle. And those two wraps will cut the tension in half, but still use the same tension here so it winds tight on the bottom.
Sorry, there's a little problem with the prototype switch right now. We have to replace it, I think. Taking, I'm just like, I don't want to like double, just taking a while to join it, just because I want to use all the ceramic here. There we go.
So a nice silky merino, how do you like it?
Hold on, let me spin it off a little bit. I love it for spinning fine, that's the only way I like to spin with it.
Interesting that you're spinning with the same tension that we were using at the very outside of the bobbin, which I just took off. And that was plenty of tension at the outside of the bobbin. And lo and behold, we've got self-adaptive plenty of tension at the inner side of the bobbin, where normally you get way too much. Which is ideal. Moving against the metal.
Just kind of, I like it. It's spinning fine.
The Chevy looks very satisfying too.
Yeah, but this is just like, it's a little more trouble to get it to do what you want it to do.
Yeah, it's much slipperier.
It's also not quite as consistent.
No, it does have some fuzzy. Also, if you're gripping it that close, I find it's quite inconsistent because the fiber is so darn long. It basically goes back 3 or 4 inches into the bat, and you'll notice a difference.
Yeah, but I can't spin good yarn that way. I need time to look at small spaces at a time. And
yeah. Well, if you get to the same speed as the take-up is giving you, so it's just super progressive, you can actually just spin at your own speed either way.
I'm being lazy.
Okay, let me fix this because I slipped off. There we go.
So this way is
this is correct.
No, which one's this way when I turn the knob this way?
That way makes it take up in the direction that you're turning the knob faster. And towards you makes it go slower. Ooh, you got set way down there. And that's a pretty good clip because it gives you some revolutions. This quiet sound is deceptive. It has a seashell. You know, when you listen to the inside of a seashell, it has that noise.
Yeah.
That violin-shaped body has two cavities.
I'm just going to spin some crappy iron real quick.
That's making a really complex, rich sound with the hardwood and the shape of the cavity.